What was it about your products that made them stand out?
Actually, when we came out with notebooks, we have our own manufacturing plant, but we subcontracted our notebook with another company. But then, you know, my father's very strict with quality. And since that company who is doing our notebooks cannot withstand our quality control, so we decided to make our own notebook. And then, but then my father has always told me, because you know there's a Chinese saying that you sell low and yet so that you can sell more. My father was saying that if you sell low, of course you should sell more, otherwise how can you make money? But the challenge my father gave to me is that sell high and yet sell more. So I can probably sell high and sell more. You know what I did? The first notebook that we came out, it's in 1976, that was a year when my father passed away. My father passed away when he was only 49, I was in my early 20s. The first notebook that we came out, my father is not around to see our first notebook coming out. But even before that, I put the notebook in the table and I looked at the notebook for around 20 minutes and said, how can I sell a notebook at a high price and yet at a bigger quantity? So if I can produce notebooks, so there are other 10 different companies that can also produce notebooks. So I said, okay, the notebook, when you saw the notebook, you saw the design first. So I said, okay, I want a design that even the kids or even the parents would like to buy. That's why at that time I make a focus group, and then I hire around 25 to 30 artists. Even the 70s, we start using computers already for designing all this. Not even the banks are using computer. We started using computers. So I said, okay, we have the best designs in the country. And then once you saw a very fancy designs notebook already, you pick it up, and then of course when you open it, then you will see the quality. Now I make sure that our notebook has always above 60 to 65 grams paper, while my competitors are going down to less than 50 grams. And then the opacity, the whiteness, the smoothness, and the line should never be broken or crooked, whatever. We enhance and maintain and even enhance the quality, so that's quality for you. And of course, as long as I'm not pricing my notebook out of competition, it's going to sell. But then, we still have to go branding, advertising. We are the first to go try media advertising. And there was an article written by J.J. Calero when he was the head of J. Walter Thompson. I make use of J. Walter Thompson, the top advertising company during that time, to do our try media. So we are the first one to do that. And then of course, we even have a jingle by Jo Marie Chan later on for our selling greeting cards. And you know, ultimately, I'm proud to say, anybody less than 50 years old here in the Philippines should know about Sterling notebooks.
Definitely.
Anybody who doesn't know about Sterling notebook, maybe he was not born here, was not educated here.
Now, speaking of being from here, your products are of such a high quality that you've been able to export them, right?
Yes. At one time, we exported it to other countries, now even Great Britain, even Singapore, or even up to Japan. That was when the peso rate was around 50 to 55 pesos. But unfortunately, the peso got stronger to 40 pesos now. Right now, we are concentrating more on the domestic market. But we have also other items that we're exporting, not necessarily paper products.
We are living in a society that is becoming more and more paperless. What is Sterling doing to address that? And how do you plan to diversify paper products in that light?
Although for offices now it can be paperless, but that's why we are really going to packaging. I would like to believe that we are the biggest paper cup manufacturing in the Philippines. These are the paper cups, and of course for environmental purposes, I think the government is trying to ban the use of plastic cups, because for paper, if you throw this away, it's going to dissolve into the soil because it's made out of trees. Mm-hmm. And of course, a lot of people said that you are destroying trees in order to produce paper, but I don't think so. Because trees, you can grow the trees anytime. And then even in other countries like Finland or New Zealand, they really grow trees. As they cut down the trees, they keep on growing the trees. Now, this is renewable. So I don't think that's going to hurt the environment. But of course, using plastic styrofoam, it's going to stay there as plastic for 500 years, 400,000 years.
Right. In the Philippines, are we able to do that? Are we able to replace the trees that are taken down from paper manufacturing?
No, I don't think we are using any trees here for paper manufacturing. because I think the biggest pulp producer is really Finland and New Zealand.
So you get your raw materials.
We get the raw
materials
there, yeah.
As you mentioned earlier, you've really diversified into real estate development and mm-hmm. agriculture. Tell me about the company's development into those areas, and why did you choose those areas in particular?
We came from a retail company. It's a bookstore, and then we go into manufacturing. And then from manufacturing, we branched back to retailing. You know, it's because of circumstances. When we came out with greeting cards, you know, greeting cards has been always the passion of my father before. But unfortunately, the greeting cards are being loaded by three big greeting cards company, Hallmark, American Greetings, and Gibson. So we came out with our own greeting cards after my father passed away because we want to keep that legacy. We had a hard time trying to put greeting cards in department stores and bookstores because they have their own brand already. So we decided to go into our own retailing. That's why we opened up Expressions. Actually, Expressions initially is it's really a social expression. So it's a card shop that you can buy Hallmark, Sterling Greetings or whatever inside the shops. But of course, it also branches out into a stationery store selling all our paper products. And then ultimately, we even branch out into department store. So from department stores, and then we go real estate. We have the best industrial subdivision in Bulacan. We have also in Laguna, in Cavite. And then, of course, we have call center. We are featuring a lot of big local brands. Like, for example, we are doing for Amber, we are doing for Jollibee, Chowking, and even Stan Cellular and Smart. So, you know, I think we would like to say that we are one of the best local call center companies, because most call centers are multinational companies. And of course, we branch out into agriculture. And